All right, joining me now is Jane Slater from the NFL Network. Jane, 9 practices in. You had a chance to see practice number 9. I guess we can talk about the quarterbacks. Why not, right?
Well, I think I've been of the opinion, like a lot of people who haven't had eyeballs at practice, that Jameis Winston is your traditional dropback passer. This is your quarterback, right? But everyone that I've talked to, whether they're in the building or outside of it, tell me that this thing is very much down the line. And that's why, as a Saints fan, if you don't get excited about the preseason should excite you, because everyone I've spoken with says preseason is when it's all going to work itself out. And so I think it's been hard for them to evaluate, given the limited amount of time that we've seen Taysom and Jameis Winston on the football field. Didn't, of course, have the OTAs. You've had, eight practices in. What they're really looking forward to seeing is them in live game action. They're both such different quarterbacks, and I've really asked, what does the offense look like? And that offense is going to adapt to whatever that skill set of that quarterback is. So they've got to figure it out soon. But I think it's nice that you've got 2 guys on this roster that are capable of doing some very different things, but also doing a lot of things similarly well.
If I had to put you on a spot, I know you've just watched 1 practice. What do you like?
I'm going Jameis. I'm of the opinion, like a lot of people, that you get the element of surprise with Taysom Hill, and his athleticism is always on display for you. Why change that? I think this is Jameis Winston's job now. It's his job to lose. So we'll just have to see how things flesh out. And I hate that for Taysom, because I'm sure Taysom gets really tired of running from the wide receiver room, the tight end room, and he's earned this on some levels. I think there was the expectation that he would be the heir apparent. But I think it's sort of nice that you're getting this from both of them. And I'm really interested to see how the rookie's doing as well.
They say a quarterback's best friend is obviously a good receiver, but they have a very good running back who's a receiver and a running back in Alvin Kamara. Could he even have a bigger season this season after what he's done last year and the year before that, year before that? Could he be even bigger this season?
I just keep going back to a 6-touchdown game on Christmas against the Vikings. I was here for that. And so I think what you've seen is, as we've seen with these running backs, they're getting smarter with their bodies. I've certainly seen that in Dallas with Ezekiel Elliott, who's dealt with some down seasons, has had to do some adjustments in the offseason. I think Alvin Kamara is a true professional in the way that he approaches his offseason and the way he approaches his in-season. And I'd like to see this team get a little bit back to using that running back a little bit more. And they might very well do that in the absence of Michael Thomas. And then, of course, Traquan Smith, I think, is about a week away from seeing him back out in the practice field.
Last question for you. Nationally, how is this team perceived now that Drew Brees is gone? A lot of the other players that were on the team last year or the year before are now gone. How are you guys nationally perceiving the Saints and Sean Payton squad?
I think very much like the fans that I speak to, it's a wait-and-see approach. I think a lot of people have confidence in what Sean Payton is capable of, but I also think that Coach likes being the underdog. I think he thrives. I think he thrives in challenges. I think he thrives when his back is against the wall. I think he really loves bulletin board material. And I look forward to seeing what this team is able to accomplish. If they can get this defense to continue doing what they're doing, and then they can find their offensive player, and maybe a guy like Marquez Callaway steps up and is, in fact, that wide receiver for you in the absence of someone like Michael Thomas, then I think that you're looking at a team that could very well compete for the NFC South.
The one and only Jane Slater from the NFL Network. Thank you, Jane.
I appreciate it. Always good seeing you guys.
You too. Back to you.